This is AgGrad Live.
We have all of the different segments within the cotton.
The show that explores what it's really like to work in the ag industry.
So making sure that we get policy and regulatory issues
straight from the people who live it every day.
You spend, you know, your career is kind of solving problems in agriculture. And I know you personally spend a lot of time thinking about sort of agriculture and the problems that exist. What do you think are challenges to our industry that maybe are top of mind for you, or perhaps we're not talking about enough?
That are top of mind. Okay, I'll probably think of a couple. The first one is going to be around, how do we talk about environmental, what people call impact, and agriculture? So we want to say that cows use water or that crops use water. But this is not a one-way system where you put water in and it can't be used for anything else, right? Water that goes on crops, much of that goes to the aquifer. Or water that a cow drinks doesn't stay in the cow for eternity, obviously. So we need a way to figure out how, as agriculturalists, to talk about environmental science and environmental social concerns in a way that's scientifically valid and also emotionally appealing. Now, the soil health movement has done a good job of trying to navigate this social appeal, but also economic reality. And we need to see more of that happen. So I think environmentalism and the conversation around it is definitely one of them. Another will be rural connectivity, rural development. This is something you've put a lot of great focus on. And we just need to figure out a way to have better access and better connectivity in rural communities. And then finally, probably population in rural areas. This trade-off we have between labor and automation. Whether you think that the tractor pushed out the farmer or that the tractor allowed the would-be farmer to go chase his or her other passions as a doctor or a lawyer or an artist. So whether you want to call the equipment the demon or the enabler, I think either could be argued, but we've got more of that coming, more automation. And it's we might even get smaller equipment in the future, because if I don't need a person in it, why do I need it to be that big, right? So that'll be a continuing theme over the next 20 years during my career, I believe.
Thank you for joining AgGrad Live. Visit aggrad.com, that's A-G-G-R-A-D, to join the community, create your profile, and learn more about careers in the agriculture industry.